family-owned business established in 1951, IKO is a worldwide leader in the roofing, waterproofing, and insulation industry with over 20 manufacturing plants throughout North America and Europe. We at IKO are proud of our long history of innovation, quality products, and customer satisfaction, as well as our employee commitment and tenacity. All principles personified by our founder, Isidore Koschitzky. In 1922, at the tender age of 17, Isidore, who was born in a small town in Poland, began his long career in the roofing industry when he worked as a salesman in his father's roofing plant, quickly demonstrating his strong work ethic and business acumen. Despite the challenging market, through Isidore's resourcefulness and innovation, the company achieved great success and opened a second plant in Warsaw. By the early 1930s, the company had come to prominence as the second largest manufacturer in the country. The invasion of Poland in September 1939 dramatically changed Isidore Koschitzky's life. He, along with his wife Golda and sons Saul and Henry, were fortunate to escape. After the war, Isidore made the decision to start a new life abroad. The Koschitzky family immigrated to Canada and arrived in Winnipeg, Manitoba in 1948, where Isidore immediately found work as a shipper in a warehouse, and Golda took a job as a seamstress. The entrepreneurial spirit never left Isidore Koschitzky, and his dream was still to start a new roofing business in Canada. He spent his spare time researching the best place to start his new venture and worked to find new partners to invest in the fledgling business. Within 6 months, he had secured financial backing and had chosen Calgary as the new home for the new company, Kola Roofing Products. While the business was successful, an unfortunate circumstance led to Isidore's partner selling the business to his competitors and left Isidore without his company. Undeterred by this setback, Isidore started over. He incorporated IKO Asphalt Roofing Products. The company first manufactured building paper, expanded to coated roll roofing, and the company made its first asphalt shingle in 1954. And the rest, as they say, is history. The company thrived, and in 1958, Isidore moved east to build a second plant in Brampton, Ontario. In 1972, a youthful 67-year-old Isidore Koschitzky decided he needed a new challenge. With both of his sons already working in the company's Toronto office, he decided that it was time to open a shingle plant in Europe. The task he set himself was not an easy one. Undeterred, he not only overcame those challenges, but made it successful. Belgium became not only a shingle plant, but a modified roll roofing plant as well, the first such plant in the IKO Group. Isidore Koschitzky personally managed the European operation for 18 years, at which time he was joined by his grandson Hartley. Isidore continued to be personally involved in the company's projects in Europe until 1994, when he passed away at the age of 89. Today, more than 60 years after its founding, the company is a worldwide enterprise with more than 3,000 employees and manufacturing plants in Canada, the United States, United Kingdom, Belgium, Holland, France, and Slovakia, selling its products to 96 countries around the globe. Yet despite tremendous growth, IKO has also remained firmly rooted in its family values, with the business remaining owned by the Koschitzky family, with three of Isidore Koschitzky's seven grandchildren currently managing its worldwide operations. Following in their father's footsteps, both Saul and Henry are both active in the global business. The ultimate proof of the company's commitment to quality and innovation is its own success. From humble beginnings to a modern manufacturer with global reach, IKO has remained committed to the values that were the foundation of the business envisioned by our founder, Isidore Koschitzky. That combination of old-time values combined with cutting-edge technology and industry-leading product quality standards and manufacturing innovation means IKO will continue to set the standard both now and in the future.